Now, with the latest information on cancer treatment, here's our reporter, Laura Windsor.
According to the American Cancer Society, more than 1.5 million people in the United States are diagnosed with cancer each year. Dr. Lisa Wang, a board-certified hematologist and oncologist at PIH Health in Whittier, California, discusses the advancements in cancer treatments in the last 10 years.
Hematology is blood disorders like anemia, thrombocytopenia, people who may have iron disorders. Those are blood disorders. But oncology, as you know, is treatment of cancer. So we are specialists in both. We treat all kinds of cancers. The top five cancers are breast cancer, lung cancer, colon cancer, prostate cancer, and lymphoma. The best approach to treating cancers nowadays is more of a multidisciplinary approach, meaning that instead of the cancer treatment being broken off into different pieces, for example, the patient goes to the surgeon, gets it resected, sees the oncologist, see the radiation oncologist, all of them doing their own individual treatments. Nowadays, we do a more multidisciplinary approach, meaning we all get together. The way we do that here is we often meet at tumor board meetings, where once the patient has a chance to meet all the specialists, we get together at the tumor board, and then we talk about the patient's case, and we review everything together, the radiologist, the surgeon, the radiation doctors, and several oncologists. We would all get together, and then we review the case as a whole. In essence, you're almost getting 20 opinions at once. And then after we come up with a decision, we go back and we go over it with the patient, make sure the patient's okay with that treatment plan, and then move forward. The number one cancer in the United States is breast cancer. And so the kind of screening we typically do for that is mammogram. And the recommended age of mammogram is at age 40. And other women who are recommended to get breast cancer screening are obviously women who have a significant family history of cancer, breast cancer at young ages, or if they have a known genetic mutation that causes them more susceptible to have cancer. Or if you have, obviously, if you self-palpated a breast lump and you're unsure, you should go get a mammogram. And mammograms nowadays, the technology itself has become more and more advanced. So for one of the examples is the 3D tomo. The 3D tomo can now see very, very, very small cancers and catch them at a very, very early stage, and sometimes even as early as stage zero. For the women who are afraid of getting mammograms because they think that they're going to have pain or if they're going to have anxiety of the mammogram itself, the 3D mammography actually is less painful than the traditional 2D mammography machines. And other screenings, of course, include colon cancer screening at age 50, and then now the newest screening we have is lung cancer screening. And so these early screening techniques are how you're going to be able to catch cancer early, because again, by the time you actually feel cancer, it's actually more advanced than you actually think it is. The earlier you detect the cancer, the more likely you will have a chance for a cure. So if you're detected at stage one, you're more likely to be cured than if you were detected at stage three, even if you did get the best treatments. Because overall, stage one, you may be able to get away with just surgery without having to go through everything else like chemotherapy and radiation. But once you're detected at stage three for whatever cancer, then the treatments become much more aggressive and it'll obviously have a lot more side effects. So the best way is to detect the cancer early. And the best way to do that is to do screening. Studies have now shown that good diet and exercise, especially a low-fat diet, can reduce risk of developing cancer. Obesity has been associated with increased risk of breast cancer and colon cancer. Having good, adequate levels of vitamin D, possibly taking a baby aspirin if that's appropriate for you, and multivitamin have also been shown to reduce risk of cancer.